Hello guys, so in this video we are going to see how to analyze a three-phase motor drive using an MSO58 oscilloscope. The setup is pretty simple. We have a three-phase motor right here. This is a permanent magnet synchronous motor, PMSM motor, and what I've done is I got my voltage breakouts right here. So these are three phases, phase A, phase B, and phase C. And the setup is pretty simple. You have three voltage probes, differential probes, connected to phase A, B, and C in phase-to-phase configuration. So VA to B, VB to C, and C to A. And then we have current probes on each of those phases, right? So we have Rogowski coil right here on phase A. There is one on phase B. And then we have this TCP probe on phase C, just because I didn't have the Rogowski coil. Now, if you're using Rogowski coil, one thing to be careful of is most Rogowski coil come with P and C terminals. So your scope is not going to know if it is current or voltage. So make sure you change the units. The conversion ratio is in the back. So you just take this in, go to your channel. So in this case, we have channel 4. Go to the configure channel. So just go to one of these channels right here and then configure it in the settings right there, right? So you just plug in that number, 20 millivolts per amp, and change the unit amps, right? So make sure you do this and scale it such that your current and voltages are within the scale, right? So that's good. Now, I've already set this up, but to make measurements, IMDA measurements, inverter motor drive analyzer, you go to IMDA and you can select power quality, which I already have here. You can select harmonics, input voltage, and I'll show you an example on the voltage, right? So if I click this, you should see a dialer right there, right? And then you can go to configure and click on configure right here. Click on the configure tab, and you'll have to tell the scope what channel is doing what, right? So you have voltage on channel 1, you have VBC on channel 2, and then VC on channel 3, right? So make sure you change this, otherwise the configuration won't match your probes. You won't get the results, right? So that's pretty much it. I did the same thing here, so you can see channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, voltage, and then currents, right? And all you have to do is make sure you have a scale that will have enough cycles so the map can measure what you're trying to measure, right? So that's it. We'll turn the motor right on. And then right here, and you can see the waveforms. And then stop it. So I can speak. And now you can see your voltage is right there. Phase A to B, phase B to C, and phase C to A. And then your currents, phase currents are right there. You can see the phase angles on each one of them. You know, at any given point, on an average, you should see 120 degrees phase shift. So red, blue, and yellow. And the current would be the same thing depending on how much the load is, right? So that's really it. And you can add more measurements by going to measure an IMDA. In addition, you can also add power measurements and so on if you're looking at electronics. But that's pretty much it. Pretty simple. Thank you.